Hello friends, thanks for clicking and welcome to my channel only for civil engineers. In this video, we will discuss about defects in timber due to fungi. First defect due to fungi is blue stain. In this image, we can see sap of this wood is stained to bluish color by the action of certain fungi. So, it is known as blue stain. Here we can see this is the blue stain. Second defect due to fungi is brown rot. In this image we can see this is the brown rot. Rot means decay or disease of timber. Therefore, fungi of certain types remove cellular compound from this wood and it attains brown color. This is known as brown rot. Third defect due to fungi is dry rot. Fungi of certain types feed on this wood and during feeding, they attack on this wood and convert it into dry powder form. This is known as dry rot. In this image, we can see here, this is the dry rot. This dry rot occurs at places where there is no free circulation of air, such as improperly ventilated basements, rooms, etc. And it is also occurs in damp situations like kitchens, toilets, etc. Unseasoned soft woods and sap wood are easily attacked by this dry rot. If timber is not properly stored after being felled down, it is liable for the attack of dry rot as shown in this image. Most favorable conditions for the rapid growth of fungus as shown in this image, responsible for dry rot are absence of sunlight, dampness, presence of sap, stagnant air and warmth. Dry rot is also caused by chairing, painting and tearing the unseasoned timber. This dry rot can be prevented by using well-seasoned timber free from sap. When part of timber is seriously affected by dry rot, the damaged portion may be completely removed and the remaining unaffected portion should be painted with a solution of copper sulfate as shown in this image. Fourth defect due to fungi is heart rot. In this image we can see here, this is the heart rot. Heart rot is formed when a branch has come out of tree and this heart wood is exposed to the attack of atmospheric agents. Ultimately, the tree becomes weak and it gives out hollow sound when struck with a hammer. Fifth defect due to fungi is sap stain. Fungi of certain types do not bring about the complete decay of timber, but they feed on cell contents of sapwood. Then the sapwood loses its color as shown in this image. This is known as sap stain. In this image we can see here, this is the sap stain. This sap stain is generally occurs when moisture content goes beyond 25%. Next defect due to fungi is wet rot. In this image we can see this is the wet rot. Some varieties of fungi cause chemical decomposition of wood of the timber, and in doing so, they convert timber into a grayish brown powder as shown in this image, and this is known as wet rot. Now, last defect due to fungi is white rot. In this image, we can see here, this is the white rot. This defect is just opposite to the brown rot. Certain types of fungi attack lignin of wood and the wood consumes the appearance of a white mass consisting of cellular compounds. So, in this image we can see white rot. Defects in timber due to fungi are finished. I hope this video will be helpful for you. For more updates, subscribe my channel and don't forget to share this video with your friends.